Good morning, dear students of class 12. Welcome to the English online learning class. Today we are going to start lesson 7 from your supplementary reader, Ivan Tries an O Level by Colin Dexter. Before we read the lesson, let us just ponder on this statement, rather a question posed by the writer. Should criminals in prison be given the opportunity of learning and education? The idea is open to the house. Should they be given the opportunity of learning or not? Well, definitely it's a corrective measure. The dramatis personae, the secretary of the examination board, the governor of HM Prison, Oxford, James Evans, a prisoner, Mr. Jackson, a prison officer, Mr. Stephens, a prison officer, the Reverend S. McLary, an invigilator, Mr. Carter, detective superintendent, Mr. Bell, detective chief inspector. All precautions have been taken to see to it that the O-level German examination arranged in the prison for Evans does not provide him with any means of escape. The lesson begins. It was in early March when the secretary of the examination board received the call from Oxford prison. So it begins with a telephonic conversation. The secretary of examination board has received a call from the Oxford prison. It is a slightly unusual request, Governor, but I don't see why we shouldn't try to help. Just the one fellow, you say? So the secretary is replying to the Governor of Oxford prison in the telephonic conversation. He says that it is an unusual request. But then, at the same time, I feel that why should the permission not be given? Why should we not try to help a prisoner in his learning? After all, this is just one fellow who has to appear for the exam. That's it, chap. Calls Evans, started 9 classes in O-level German last September, says he's dead keen to get some sort of academy qualification. So the governor is replying. He says, yes, the chap who wants to appear for the exam is Evans, and already 9 classes in O-level German last September began to tutor him. It was arranged in prison. But now he is keen to get some sort of academic qualification. Is he any good? The secretary of board examination poses a question. The reply by the governor. He was only one in the class. So you can say he had individual tuition all the time, really. Would have cost him a packet if he had been outside. So the governor replies that as he was just one student, it was a kind of individual tuition. But this would have really cost him a lot had he taken this individual tuition outside. But in the prison, it is free of cost for him. Well, let's give him a chance, shall we? That's jolly kind of you. What exactly is the procedure now? So, the secretary agrees. He says we would give him a chance. Now, governor is very thankful. And then he wants to know the modalities of conducting the examination. Oh, don't worry about that. I'll be sending you all the forms and stuffs. What's his name? You say Evans. So, secretary says, don't worry. All the documentation part related to exam will be taken care of by us. And then he wants to know his name, Evans. James Roderick Evans. It sounded rather grand. So he gives him his complete name and says that it is quite grand. Just one thing, Governor. He's not a violent sort of fellow, is he? I don't want to know his criminal record or anything like that. But the secretary says, just one thing we would like to be clear about. Is he any violent sort of a prisoner or not? Please inform. Otherwise, we are not keen to know his criminal record. The governor's reply. No, there's no record of violence. Quite a pleasant sort of chap, they tell me. Bit of a card, really. One of the stars at the Christmas concert. Imitations, you know the sort of thing. Mike Yarfoot stuff. No, he's just a congenital kleptomaniac. That's all. The governor was tempted to add something else, but he thought better of it. He'd look about that particular side of things himself. So the governor is replying to secretary's query about what sort of a person was Evans. He says there is no record of violence. He's quite a pleasant sort of a person and he's a bit of a game. In the Christmas concerts, he is a star. He's very good at imitating this kind of Mike Yardfoot stuff. He is just a congenital kleptomaniac. Means he's suffering from a disease where he just takes person which does things which does not belong to him. He steals. It's a kind of disease. He's a kleptomaniac. Otherwise, he is not violent. He wanted to add something else, but he thought that may go negative. And he is going to take care of that particular aspect himself. Presumably, said the secretary, you can arrange a room where. So now the modalities for conducting the exam are being worked out. The secretary says that you could probably arrange a room. No problem. He's in a cell on his own. If you have no objections, he can sit the exam in there. So the governor says that he is housed in a cell of his own. He's not sharing it with others. And if you allow, we can have the exam there. That's fine. And we could easily get one of the parsons from St. Mary's Mat to invigilate if that's so. The modalities are being worked out. The secretary says that probably one of the parsons from St. Mary's Mat can invigilate. Fine, yes. They seem to have a lot of parsons there, don't they? The two men chuckled good-naturedly. Means they had a nice talk. Very smoothly it ran. And the secretary had a final thought. At least there's one thing. You shouldn't have much trouble keeping him incommunicado, should you? The governor chuckled politely once more, reiterated his thanks and slowly cradled the phone. Evans. So, finally, the approval was given from the Secretary of Board Examination that the German O-level exam would be conducted for Evans in Oxford Prison and the documentations required would be sent by the board. And one of the parsons from St. Mary's Mag would be coming to invigilate. He wanted some background information about Evans, which the governor gave, not fully, partially, just one information he did not like to share, he did not want to share with the secretary, thinking that it might go against him, and that aspect he is going to take care of himself. He informed the secretary that there is no record of violence against Evans. He is a pleasant person. He has a lot of qualities. He is a star at Christmas concerts. He is good at imitating. He suffers from a congenital disease. He is a kleptomaniac. Otherwise, he is a nice person. He is keen to learn. He is keen to appear in an examination, German O-level examination that would give him some sort of an academic qualification. We'll stop here and we'll continue with the remaining in the next class. Thank you.